bug-eyed monsters that don't come from outer space. They're Goonie Birds, a top attraction at the Toy and Hobby Fair in Birmingham's National Exhibition Centre. It's not what you do, it's the way that you do it. For instance, take Guy the Gorilla. Little girls still sigh over dolls and dolls' houses. This desirable residence is all electric, and it's made in Sweden. The furniture is made of wood and plastic, and nothing is forgotten. The toy fair is probably one of the biggest growth industries in Britain, and this, the biggest fair ever. Toy production at retail prices last year, £1 million a day. The things you can do with plasticine or material like it. Watch this little chap grow from Yulbrynner to the creature from the outer swamp. Don't go away, there's more to come. Considered an expert at most indoor pastimes, Omar Sharif can chat up a girl and play backgammon. Resurrected for the jet set in the early 70s, backgammon still going strong. Stevenson's rocket returns to amuse 20th century kids. Steam-powered like the original, its scale to 1/16th is 15 inches long and comes with 25 feet of permanent way. The rocket even has the original colours. The fuel is ordinary lighter fluid. Maximum speed, walking pace, so there's no problem with runaways. Model railways usually steal the show at all toy fairs, and this year is no exception. The 9.5 foot long Duchess, though, is strictly for the big boys. In fact, it'll soon be running over a 1.25 mile track at Park Railway, Walsall. The coal-fired Duchess can haul 6 tons or 30 people. Like a true Duchess, she's expensive, £8,000. Since do-it-yourself became a sort of religion, the toy business has never looked back. 500 dealers from 30 countries have come to the Toy and Hobby Fair. With that certain picture packing them in worldwide, toy producers haven't been slow to take the hint. Star Wars has brought more bizarre costumes to the screen than even Hollywood can remember. Mums and dads are in for some visual shocks when they go toy shopping this year. For the first time in cinema history, set and costumes from a screen spectacular have become museum pieces even before the first showing. At London Science Museum, youngsters of every age are drawn to this cavalcade of way-out stars. This has been the biggest build-up of any motion picture. Characters like C-3PO and R2-D2 promise to become as familiar as Snow White and Mickey Mouse. In true Hollywood tradition, they bid to become the screen's first lovable robots. British actors include Alec Guinness as Ben Kenobi and Peter Cushing. Mark Hamill plays Luke Skywalker in the £6 million epic. The attendance at Star Wars has been almost astronomic. Queues are still forming. In America, more money was taken at box offices in 1 week than for the prestigious Jaws. In London, after a month, almost 600,000 flocked to see the film, an all-time record. What is the attraction of Star Wars? Who can say? There have been lavish spectaculars before. Perhaps it's because this one takes the best from all the rest. Color, breathless excitement, fantasy. And because we on this planet are already touching space with a tentative finger, more reality than we care to admit. fact is, Star Wars is out of this world.
Which way? All right, men, load your weapons.
Stop that ship! Blast them!
I've forgotten how much I hate space travel.
Lost lateral control!
Don't worry. You'll hold together.